Hi, my name's TJ, and I'm here today to talk to you about the Layout Switcher widget for Win10Widgets. Layout Switcher allows you to save two different widget layouts and effortlessly switch between them. Layout Switcher can automatically switch between layouts, or you can manually choose which layout to use at any given time. The first layout, Layout 1, is meant to be used as a single screen layout. Most people set Layout 1 as their laptop layout. The second layout, Layout 2, is meant to be used as either a dual screen layout or a monitor layout. Most people set Layout 2 as their laptop and monitor layout. Layout Switcher is meant to blend into the background. Therefore, its default state is semi-transparent, as we can see over here. When we hover over the icon, it becomes opaque. There are two color options to choose from when using Layout Switcher, light and dark. These options can be found by right-clicking, selecting Custom Skin Actions, and then either selecting light icon or dark icon. I'll show you the dark icon now, but I'm going to switch back to the light icon for visibility purposes. There are also four sizes to choose from when using Layout Switcher. These sizes can be found by right-clicking, selecting Variants, and then selecting the size of your choice. There's large, we have medium, there's small, and then finally we have tiny, which might be hard to see, so I'm going to switch back to medium. Layout Switcher will either appear as a laptop icon or a monitor icon, depending on the situation. If only one screen is detected, the laptop icon will be shown. If two screens are detected, the monitor icon will be shown. I'm using two screens right now, so the monitor icon is being shown. Inside each icon will either be an A for auto layout, a 1 for layout 1, or a 2 for layout 2. When auto layout is enabled, layout 1 will automatically be loaded when only one screen is detected, and layout 2 will automatically be loaded when two screens are detected. I'll show you this now by unplugging my second monitor. Since only one monitor is detected, layout 1 has been loaded. I'll plug the monitor back in and we'll see layout 2 load. There we go. Now, the first time you use Layout Switcher, you'll need to set up and save your layouts. This is accomplished in two easy steps per layout. The first step is to arrange your widgets in an order that you like. Since I already have my widgets laid out, step one is taken care of. Step two is to right-click the Layout Switcher, select Custom Skin Actions, and then click Set Layout 1 or Set Layout 2, depending on which layout you're trying to set. Since I'm using Layout 2, I'm going to select Set Layout 2. A pop-up is shown, signifying that Layout 2 has been set. Simply click OK, and you're good to go. Now, if you want to change your layouts manually instead of using Auto Layout, there are two ways of doing this. You can either click the icon to cycle through the layouts. The order is Auto Layout, Layout 1, Layout 2, and then back to Auto Layout. So I'll show you this now. I'll click, and we move to Layout 1. I'll click again, and we move to Layout 2. One more time, and we're back at Auto Layout. The second way of manually changing your layout is to right-click, select Custom Skin Actions, and then either click Load Layout 1, Load Layout 2, or you can click Auto Layout. That's pretty much it. Now there's one more thing I want to talk to you about regarding Layout Switcher, and that is what happens if you accidentally lose the widget. Now this can happen if you're using a light icon on a light background or a dark icon on a dark background. I'm going to simulate this now by making the light icon small and placing it over the W. Now we can't see it, so we can't really use the Layout Switcher. So what are we supposed to do? It's an easy problem to solve. Simply go to the notification area, right-click the rain meter icon, which is a raindrop, select Win10Widgets Layout Switcher, and then change the color exactly like we did before by selecting Custom Skin Actions and selecting the color of your choice. I'm going to switch to the dark icon, and now we can find the Layout Switcher. That's pretty much it. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please subscribe. And I hope you guys really like your widgets. If you do, I'd really appreciate it if you could share them on social media. If you love your widgets, I would really, really appreciate it if you could go to donate.win10widgets.com and donate to help me pay off my student loans. College is expensive, and I could really use all the help I can get. Now, you're by no means obligated to do this, but I thought if you were feeling generous, I'd provide a link for you guys to help out. So thanks, and I hope you guys all have a fantastic day.